You look like John Lennon. John Lemon.
Hi, I'm James Welsh.
And I'm Robert Welsh.
And welcome to the 70s.
Wait, everyone did this.
Whoa.
Wait, did they?
They were like this.
And their arms did this.
Yeah.
For no reason.
Yeah, fact.
And
historically accurate fact.
Just my arms.
Why don't you put a hole through it and put one on your middle finger? To cover up your hands.
Why would I ever want to cover up my
is
hands?
Is the point in this not to... Oh, no. I don't know. What's happening with your outfit?
This is my flesh.
Oh, it's your flesh. Okay. Welcome to another historically accurate You Will Find No Mistakes Here.
Not one.
Not one. Makeup, skincare routine of the 1970s. An interesting time in cosmetics.
Yeah, no, it was.
I think we had a lot of kind of like... you know, what could be considered what are we doing?
Progressive
attitudes towards women in general. We had the first female president in the UK president. The UK president.
No,
the first female
prime minister.
Margaret Thatcher.
Boo.
Women's rights. No, what are we talking about? We had equal pay, sexual discrimination acts passing. Still questionable to this day. And along with that came a lot of kind of like freedom and expression of like makeup and trends.
Everyone's doing this.
You know, wanting to make the most of how you looked. Everyone's going like this.
Yeah. Doing this.
Was that the
70s?
No, I think that's the 50s.
Was that 60s?
No, I don't know.
What's Austin Powers?
Very accurate. 60s?
Is that the 70s?
Oh, I don't know. I thought it was the 60s. The 70s had two main trends, which I think we're all very, very familiar with.
Which is kind of just like, anyway.
It is kind of, I feel like people always divide into two groups when it comes to cosmetics, but this one's very, I feel like, very reflective of nowadays. We had our hippies, right? So you can imagine they are the clean beauty brigade of today.
They're all doing this.
Find that music. So obviously they were all natural.
Yeah.
What we would call today. They loved very minimal looks. They loved very kind of natural approaches to skincare. They loved rubbing leaves.
Soap.
They never used electricity.
Never once.
Never. They did a lot of nothing to their hair.
Yeah.
Very natural kind of thing. On the other hand, we obviously had kind of the whole rise in disco and glam. I don't know what we're thinking of.
No, I don't either. I don't know.
Was 70s Baywatch? No.
That's the 90s, 80s.
We know our history, huh? which was very glam. We had a lot of fake tan. We had a lot of interest in cosmetics. So let's go through a few of the main bits, shall we?
All right, let's go.
Let's do that, shall we?
And then one of these, like, a slidey, like, with all the colours behind us.
Yeah.
Mid-break for no reason. We're going to do this if, like, that was the 70s, 60s.
Yeah, I think it was the 60s.
I think it was
thinking of.
No, I think it was. Was it the 60s?
Oh, shit.
Disregard everything we just said about dancing. Alexa. There's not one in this room. When?
So we're thinking of a wrong...
Well, if you think about it, 60s still had very much kind of like 50s kind of approach to fashion. A lot of women were still wearing like dresses and had bigger hair and stuff. Whereas in the 70s, for example, let's talk about this one product first of all, a fragrance.
Yeah.
Charlie actually...
They had one of the first campaigns of a woman wearing trousers.
There's a fragrance that's here too. Charlie, kind of free, kind of wow. Charlie, kind of fragrance that's gonna stay, and it's here now. Charlie,
Charlie by Revlon, a most original fragrance.
Can you believe it?
That's so in the 70s.
Yeah, and it really kind of like empowered everyone to be like, yeah, I can wear, I'm going to wear jeans.
I'm going to, fuck it, I'm going to wear jeans.
This very much looks like the original bottle, but Charlie would be in the corner here, diagonal, and it wouldn't say Charlie. Charlie Red was a bit more popular than Charlie Blue.
I swear people used to wear Charlie Red in school.
It smells exactly the same. Is that not Charlie Red? Just a bit mustier.
That's soap. That's a very clean smell.
That's Charlie.
Oh my god, Ashton's become overcome. She's going... Even though it's wrong.
But this was one of the... I feel like this was still popular when we were in school, but it moved into like body spray
form. It was Charlie Red, right?
And it was like...
Yeah.
Body spray form. But yeah, very, very popular.
Yeah.
I believe they did like makeup as well, didn't they? Charlie, they had like nail polishes and all that kind of stuff. I think they had a bit more of a... We do know, but we're not telling you because we know our history.
It's the 70s.
But also, this was a time where brands started to acknowledge darker skin tones. So you had cover models, people in the front of magazines, black celebrities being the faces of like particular makeup brands and cosmetic brands
getting
as well.
Campaigns.
People like
getting
Aretha Franklin.
And blessed.
Yeah, booked and blazed. People like Aretha Franklin, for example, but also Avon, can you believe, was one of the first beauty brands to actually do this.
Avon?
Yeah, and having like kind of like the colours available for people with darker skin tones. It's obviously not quite what it is today, but they were starting to acknowledge the darker, deeper skin tones. Tan became such a huge thing, and a lot of the self-tanning
mitts.
No, what they called?
Gloves.
No, taglines were like, the darker, the better.
Oh.
So a lot of people are literally going out, becoming the darkest they can become.
Yeah.
So it is argued that a lot of these brands were kind of catering for white women who had made themselves darker kind of thing. But, you know, we were still having these black cover models a lot as well. Now, speaking of tan, it was an issue. It was a really big issue.
Don't paint it on.
No, I can't talk if it's trapped here.
It's definitely not a 70s. It's not. It's definitely not. It's more disco, right?
Disco, yeah.
What's a disco one?
Do you believe?
No, that was...
Mark's put a beach behind us, even though that's the 50s, 60s.
Everybody's got surfing.
Smurfing USA. Fake tan and real tan. So obviously real tan became huge. People using oils. Brands would advertise their tanning oils as safe, but they had factors like 2, 4, and 8.
Ew.
Yeah, but then they'd also say things like, we have coconut oil, we have lanolin, all these things that help moisturize the skin to stop you aging whilst giving you a deeper, darker tan quicker.
Sunblast.
But obviously there's no safe tan where you're not wearing a tanning
lanolin on your body in the sun.
Grizzy, shiny,
grizzy,
suffocating.
Yeah.
But obviously this would kind of like almost like cook your skin, you know, because you, and these were in oils as well,
like a 70s turkey.
Yes, like a good Fanny Craddock turkey.
Yeah.
Now but then obviously because people tanning became such a huge thing, fake tan became such a huge thing as well, and there were like things that are like, we've got a minute, get a tan. And these campaigns
in 1 minute
literally just showed orange women who had aged by about 50 years. Don't mean like next year. They were awful.
It was all new.
But this was the year that brands were required to start putting sun protection factors on their tanning products, their oils, their SPFs, all that kind of stuff.
It got you.
Let me just check Ashton's notes again.
Ashton makes really
I did do a bit of research. Okay.
Oh.
No, I wasn't going to spray that. Oh no, it's going to be on you for like a week
now. Oh my god.
Oh, you smell like every teacher ever.
Oh my god, I do.
It's clean.
It makes me want to do this.
It's very Body Shop white musk, isn't it?
Yeah, absolutely.
Now listen, popular brands back then. Charlie, Oil of Olay, which used to be called Oil of Olam.
Earlum.
And Elizabeth Arden, would you believe it or not?
She's always doing it.
She's always been around.
Yeah.
In fact, she's been around for centuries.
Yeah.
And CoverGirl. Ponds and CoverGirl as well. Ponds have been in, I think, every historically accurate video we've ever done.
Since the Victorian times,
right?
Or was it Victorian?
I feel like it was before then.
Have we done Romans? We haven't done Romans. Pons wasn't around in the Roman times.
We haven't done Romans.
Romans, write that down. Write that down.
Imagine me as a Venus.
Wait, was that Romans?
Great. I don't know. Oh, I'm thinking of Ptephany. Who's that? Athena, that's it. Hygiena. Refrigerator. Da, da,
da, da. So by the 1970s, that makes it sound so old. 1970s.
I know it does. It's not that long
by the
ago,
1970s,
really.
Yeah. Skincare routines were already in force.
They were in force.
Everyone was doing them. But again, as I said, we had this natural kind of take. So brands are really focusing on their natural ingredients. So one of the most popular cleansers at the time, where's my soap? Here we go. Was Yardley's Lavender Soap. I'm off all the time. Now, I'm not going to use this because you know what?
What?
Soap's extremely drying.
But
this is the kind of soap you'll get free in a hotel. It's lavendery. Oh. Where are the ingredients?
Yeah, pop that in your wardrobe. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
It's basically got all your usual soap ingredients.
Like soap.
Soap, perfume.
She
got glycerin,
blue.
Linalool. So, you know, it might not be as stripping and drying, but...
Yardley's another classic as well, been around for many, many years.
Use this for your hands, you'll be fine. But of course, Yardley's, we still know today, are one of those brands that really do focus on like very, I feel like very British, like grow in your garden kind of ingredients.
Yeah, it's kind of like you imagine like an elderly woman, she's opened her cottage door, she's like, oh shit, I've got so much lavender, she makes soap.
Yeah, I'm just going to make soap and hang it in my wardrobe.
Yeah.
So the next stage is of course toner, and of course we have our sea breeze.
Wow, that's so 3D, I can hardly stand it.
Again, old toners, very astringent, but this was still considered a key step in your skincare routine, especially for teenagers, if you wanted that clear skin, problematic-free skin, all that kind of stuff. Bio Russia Reversage was also really, really popular, but if you know skincare, you still know to this day, it's really hard to get your hands on.
What is it, sorry?
It's like an exfoliating toner.
For your body?
For your face.
Oh.
Yeah. So hard to get your hands on and very, very expensive as well, in my personal opinion, but a really good product if you get your hands on it. Let's talk about oil of olum.
Olum.
This is when, like, anti-aging became, like, a real thing because of, like, all the sun, and people knew the sun damaged your skin, but it was all about aftercare rather than prevention. You know, if you don't sunbathe, you're not going to get wrinkly.
If it's happened.
But oil of olive, of course, is still used by many people everywhere because it's very readily available. Pop down to Bouet's, it's in there.
It's right there.
It's right there. Should we use some of this?
Yeah, what is it?
This is the Oil of Olay Beauty Fluid, face and body moisturizing fluid for normal, dry, and combo skin.
Oh. No.
Oh my God. That brings back memories.
That's such a memory.
This is like, you know what this smells like. This smells like your grandmother's moisture, the first scratch and sniff page of Avon.
Yeah.
Oh, that's kind of like... Is this stuff that they were using as like a primer? Oh no, that was like a Nivea for Men thing, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, that's nice. A beauty
that smells, fluid. It smells really, really good. Mm. And it's very silky on the skin.
It's very, quite, I don't mind that, you know?
Shine.
Oh, I love that. So yeah, very, very popular. Still to this day. I'm surprised you can still buy it like this.
I know, it's very basic, but a classic again. You don't have to change a classic.
And that's really like the key instrumentals of a 1970s skincare routine and what it was popular to have your skin looking like.
It was very much a basic cleanse tone, right?
Yeah.
Mm.
Yeah.
So let's talk about makeup. Like you said, there were like two extremes. One, we had this really nice, all natural, like hippie vibe, but not much makeup at all, if any. Oh, my boobs are so wet. And then on the other side, we had a little, it still wasn't heavy and over the top, but we did have a little bit of color on the lids. Crease was defined a little bit, all blended out, no harsh lines. And tints everywhere. So let's start with the eyes, shall we? As you can see, my eyebrows are very natural.
Yes, they're blonde naturally.
And skin was also very natural. So I'm actually just going to leave it like this, actually, Jace.
Yeah, you do look bronzed for the gods boots the house.
Boots a wig house, boots wig bronze wig house.
Down.
So I'm just going to apply a very light, almost pastely, very delicate purpley shade to my lid, like so.
Are you not showing the palette for a reason?
Yeah, because this isn't from the 70s.
Oh, right, yeah.
What brands would they have used back then? CoverGirl.
Aura Roulay.
Oh,
it depends what country you were in, doesn't it? It was there wasn't like, there was the basics like Revlon, Revolution. No, I'm joking. They had one of everything, and it has tan, fizz sticks, candles.
Revolution, oh God.
Fizz sticks. So I'm using like a lighter colour on the lid, because this is very much a muted, very like, you know, if your eyelids were naturally purple.
Which a lot of people do.
Oh yeah, James.
Yeah, same.
Shimmer was popular back then, maybe not in the crease like I'm about to do, but almost pearlescent, like, you know.
Yeah,
like
you're just about to go to the club, Studio 54?
I think 54. That's the wrong era again.
There's tinfoil all over the walls for some reason. Studio 54 was the 70s.
Was it?
Yeah. Andy Warhol.
He's an artist.
Artist. Studio 54 was his, right?
Wow, you look like Farrah Fawcett. I feel like Farrah Fawcett.
Yeah, you look like Farrah Fawcett.
See how just natural and beautiful I look.
Yeah.
Ow!
I know what you mean, but it's still kind of natural, but looks nice.
It's almost like a wash of colour.
Yeah.
Like, is she? Isn't she?
Yeah.
Is she so Charlie?
Yeah, is she Charlie Red?
A little bit of shimmer under her brow here. And this is like the carelessness I assume they put their makeup on with back.
You look like all of ABBA.
In the day. Yeah. You can do it!
Were they the 70s? Yeah, they were the 70s, right?
People are here for that kind of information.
ABBA was 70s.
And now I look like all Charlie's Angels.
You do, all of them mixed up together.
Okay, mascara. This is a classic and is probably one of the best mascaras ever. This is Great Lash, and the 70s were a time when mascara moved from cake into this little bag.
What do you mean cake? Like a pancake.
Oh,
into a tube.
Mm.
So they didn't use wands before?
Or was they didn't like have, they had little brushes, and I believe there was a squeezy tube before, but this is when we have this plastic, like this kind of thing. Mm. And this mascara, Maybelline? Yeah. Great Lash has been around for centuries.
Centuries.
Since the Victorian times. No, wait, Maybelline did have mascara since the Victorian times. So mascara on her bottom lashes wasn't like the most popular, and false lashes weren't that popular either. But I am going to do quite a little bit of a chunkier bottom lash because I have really shit eyelashes, so this isn't going to look so great, actually.
That moisturizer feels really nice, you know.
And how do you feel now?
I it's really like... I feel like this.
Yeah, that's because it's Brulen.
Orololum.
Now, James, did you know Benetint was made for nips? The nipper.
None of those words meant anything to me then.
Benetint. Do you know what Benetint is?
No.
A typical man not knowing what Benetint is.
What the fuck is Benetint? Oh, like that tin?
Yes.
Oh.
So Benetint was made for a fancy dancer to redden the nips. And Benetint came up with Benefit, came up with Benetint.
Oh.
Which is this. But a very flush of colour was very much a 70s vibe. Going into the 80s, it was very like strong and up here. But we're going to do like the smallest amount. And I'm going to do it like more like here. So it's in between our cheeks and the cheekbone. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So
we're
not over accentuating any part excessively.
Oh,
it is me, all of Charlie's Angels. As you mentioned, bronzer was such a thing.
Yeah, from what I saw, they had like the fake tan as we know it today, but also like bronzing sticks, which are like lip balm.
Bronzer still wasn't like too excessive because we still want to see our skin. You know what I mean? It was all about healthy skin. Whether you were a hippie or a dancer.
Whether you were sunburned to death or not. It's so funny because like back then, even though men did tan, all the adverts were like, bronzing and tan is not for your mother or your brother.
Why would it not be for your mum?
I don't know. Because I don't know.
Who says mums don't want
I think
to
it's
tan?
Meant to be like young, successful, up and coming women.
Let's know if you're a mum and you tan. Down below.
Don't tell me if you tan on purpose, please. I won't be happy.
Oh, I'll see.
Do you think I look like a celebrity?
Yes. Anyone can
Which
be a celebrity.
Which one?
Or them.
The one, the main one.
Which celebrity?
The main one with the hair and the shiny breasts.
The one with the wet boobs. This kind of light pink against a tan look was very much a thing.
Oh, plash.
What celebrities do I look like?
Billie Eilish.
No.
I don't know who she is. I just said a name.
70s one.
I don't know. Farrah Fawcett.
Yeah.
Pamela Anderson.
I just did.
Keep it.
Pamela Anderson wasn't 70.
Well, I don't know. You put me on the spot.
To be fair, we don't really know what we're doing.
No.
Oh, and French tips.
Marcus, something 70s.
This is actually quite a nice...
Yeah, I quite like...
Like, welcome break from many colours on the eyes,
yeah.
You know. Couture. Yeah.
Well, there we go. That's the...
You've got food to try.
Oh.
Do we?
Yeah.
Oh!
Listen, as a special surprise, because there isn't really much to the 70s look, we are going to try some classic dishes from the 70s.
Listen, 70s cooking shows are one of my favourite things to laugh at because the absolute shite that they used to make.
It's like wrap it in foil.
Put potato in jelly for some reason.
Let's go and have a look now at the special occasion picnic.
What is it?
Are you recording?
Yes.
Oh my God. Ashton, this has taken you hours. We have a classic pineapple and cheese hedgehog.
Look at the eyes.
Oh, he's so cute. He's got a little nose. Ashton.
Oh, has it? But you know what? Room temperature cheese is really nice.
Been in your car for a week.
Wait a minute.
Please. This is like the perfect party.
Yeah. Imagine like you've just got a house that has a
microwave.
No, I was thinking about those blocks of glass.
Mm, what a great combination.
I do genuinely really like room temperature cheese. It's so nice.
Mm. Pineapple gives me diarrhea.
Mm.
Listen, if you want to impress me, make a fucking cheese and pineapple hedgehog and serve it.
70s weren't so bad.
And a vol-au-vent.
I fucking knew it. I want to die. I want to die.
What is this?
This jello
salad? No!
Wait a second.
Quick, focus on it.
I think it's fucking...
What flavour is this, Ashton?
Orange.
Wait, it's salad, so it's got actual... It's not fruit, it's salad. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. My God.
I'm so nervous.
So they were actual jelly flavours with salad in. Is this a recipe from somewhere?
Thank you.
I just saw a picture.
I thought it was like gelatin.
I'm going to get a good wedge of cucumber.
Wait, this can't be right. This can't be right.
Is that a carrot, Ashton?
This can't be real.
Why is there a carrot in here? A bit of carrot.
Oh, it's like pins. Ashton, is that...
It's like...
Is that lettuce?
No, it just looks like a bit of lettuce. Like, yeah. I did try a bit of a carrot with it.
This isn't bad,
It's
though.
Strangely, like, refreshing.
Oh.
It's got, like, a gin and tonic-y Pimm's kind of refreshing. It's so weird.
It tastes like an adult beverage.
I can't stop eating it.
Wait, I feel like this can't be right. I still feel like no one could have made this.
No, I feel like this is a thing.
It is a thing.
I feel like it's in America. I feel like people in America still do it.
Lettuce. Look at the lettuce. I'm down.
Oh. Mm. I'm really enjoying this.
No, I am.
Mm. We got a spoon. Try some.
Awesome. You're mad.
It's... Right.
Oh, that carrot was a bit too real.
I can't get the lettuce. It's gone really soggy. I can't get it.
Thank you, Ashton. Yeah. Wow. I'm full.
Is that what I thought was a stew earlier? Is that all of it?
Yeah.
Thanks, Ashton.
I want
to try more jelly salads.
Can you imagine a strawberry jelly with tomatoes?
What's that marshmallow one that Americans make? And it's like, like
a sweet potato pie with...
No.
Yeah,
marshmallow salad, ambrosia salad.
Oh yeah, that sounds good though.
Yeah, it does look good. It looks
sounds
like an
really good.
Mess, but I like it.
Well, God, what a time spin. No, it was a time slip. No.
Yeah, that'll do.
Yeah. What a time slip.
Welcome. No.
Yeah, welcome. Yeah, welcome. Yeah. Yeah, why not?
Yeah, so...
why not?
Listen, know? Check out our historically accurate playlist. I presume we have one. Yeah, like here somewhere... No, that's my outro. That's my thingy channel outro. Sorry. Check it out anyway.
Have you put garlic in that jelly? Oh,
no.
What's that taste?
It's fragrant. No spring onion or anything, no.
It's definitely like an onion taste.
It's probably the cheese mixed up with the jelly.
It's probably the lettuce.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Spicy lettuce. And check out our podcast here. You can follow me, James_S_Welsh, on Instagram and TikTok, and James Welsh here on YouTube.
And you can follow me, Robert Welsh, here on YouTube.
Amen.
Okay. How are you wearing an Apple Watch in the 70s?
It's gonna be, I'm going to be one of those unexplained videos where it's like, yeah, time traveler.
Number five. Is he a time traveler?
70s time traveler.
Time traveling foot lettuce.
Bye.
Bye.